Hey, this is John Sonmez from SimpleProgrammer.com. And I've got another question for you. This question comes from Michael, and Michael says, Hi John, I was wondering if you had time to help me with something. I'd like to do independent software testing, have wanted to for about a year and a half, and things seem to be lining up to make that possible. I'm capable of each aspect of the task, from finding clients to providing the service. No part of the process seems spooky. In fact, every part seems fun. I get excited talking to people about my plans, but for the past few months, I haven't had much progress in getting going. I'm not sure what's stopping me, so I was wondering if you had any advice on what might be causing this inertia, or I'm assuming he means, oh yeah, I guess it is inertia, right? Is this something common? Looking forward to hearing back. Thanks, Michael. So Michael, this is definitely common, right? This is, you know, there's a struggle. I have this chart that I often talk about where what ends up happening, like anytime you pursue anything new, is that when you start off, your motivation level is really, really high, right? So, and it sort of starts to peak, and then it goes way, way, way down, and there's this wall here, right? And so you hit this wall, and then you've got your sort of, the results, right? The results, when you first start out something, you get really big results right away, and then again, just like the motivation, it drops down. Pretty soon, you know, as a beginner, you learn something really rapidly, but then you start to realize how much you actually suck at it, and you hit this wall where you're not getting results. And so this wall really gets in your way, right? It stops you. And that's where a lot of people are at, and that's where you're probably hitting, right? If you wanted to learn to play guitar, what would happen is you'd be really excited, oh, I'm gonna learn how to play guitar. You'd be pumped about it. You'd start to learn. Pretty soon you'd realize that your fingers are hurting, right? And at first you'd get good, like you'd learn a few chords and you'd be like, oh look, I can play a couple of songs, and that would happen really rapidly. And then pretty soon you'd stagnate and you'd start to not be as motivated anymore, and you're not making as much progress, and you realize it's gonna be a lot of work before you become Jimi Hendrix, right? It's gonna take time, and then you're gonna hit this wall. And this is the wall that separates the champions from the losers, if I'm gonna be blunt here, right? And this wall exists for a good reason, right? It's because not everyone can be the best. Not everyone can be great. And this wall holds them back and makes it so only a few people pass through. So anyone who's become good at anything, you know, the best guitarists in the world, the best musicians, they hit this wall, and what they do is they keep going. They don't have the motivation, they're not seeing the results, but they keep on practicing. They keep on pushing through, and they're able to do that because they realize that once they get through this wall, on the other side is the gold. It's the place where other people aren't willing to go. And the question is, are you willing to go there? Now, again, I don't know a whole lot about your situation, just what you've said in this email, but I would say that you're probably at this point. You know, you said that you were really motivated and really, really gung-ho about this thing, but you know, it's probably waned a little bit, right? Your motivation, the results that you were seeing, and so you're probably at this point where you're just not feeling it. And you have to push through this if you want to become great, if you want to succeed at this. You know, I've hit this so many times in my life with so many of the different things I've done in business where, you know, I'm super excited about this project or this thing, but finishing it is really, really hard, right? That's where, you know, the going gets tough. You know, the tough have to get going. You have to be able to push through and get through this wall. And then there's huge, huge rewards on the other side. So again, I can't say for sure that this is what's going on with you, but it sure sounds like it. It sounds like you probably are at this point where you're not seeing the results, and you know, it's gonna take time. Again, you know, you think about all the different areas where there's greats, right? You know, think about like Olympics, you know, Olympic level athletes. They're the ones who are willing to practice every day when it stops being fun, right? You know, a lot of people don't have the guts to do this. When something stops being fun or they lose their motivation, they stop and they give up. They don't ever have the the gumption to see something through to become a great. So, you know, if you're going to start a business, especially, this is a critical aspect, right? Most businesses fail really not because it couldn't succeed, but because the person running the business gave up. They couldn't make it through the hard times. They couldn't get to the end. But I want to give you a glimmer of hope here. You know, if you're able to push through, that's where, you know, this becomes a good thing, right? This wall becomes a really, really good thing, because what it means is that the competition at the top near the summit of the mountain, there's not very many people up there. So you don't have much competition. You know, when you start off a marathon, there's a lot of people at the starting line, but there's less people at the finish line. So are you going to be the kind of person that's going to make it to the finish line? In order to do that, you need a process and a routine. You need to understand why you're doing a thing. If you're constantly wake up every morning and you only do things when you feel motivated to do them, you're never gonna succeed. You won't be good. You won't ever build this business. But if you wake up every morning and you have this vision of something distant in the future, of what you wanna accomplish and what you wanna become, and you know that the path to get there is gonna be a lot of pain and a lot of drudgery, but it'll be worth it and it'll be worth the reward, then you'll get there because you'll force yourself to do it. You won't feel like doing things, but you'll do them anyway. And that's the key that really separates someone who's a champion versus someone who ends up being a loser. So your choice, hopefully you choose the right choice, and hopefully it's the right path for you. That's the other thing, is maybe you're not on the right path. But if you pick a path, stick to the path and make it through to the end, and then only then will you really see the rewards. All right, well, hopefully this video is helpful to you, and hopefully it's helpful to any of you that are watching it. If you would like me to answer a question for you, just email me at john@simpleprogrammer.com, and I will try to get a video out to you. Take care, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel.